Welcome to Media Minute. For this episode, we're talking bad Christmas presents and weird history. We'll be back right after this. Welcome to Media Minute. I'm Michael Forward.
I'm Chris Raskowski.
And we're back again for another episode. I think last episode we mentioned we might be talking about some bad Christmas presents, but
yeah, we made a promise we didn't deliver
we
did, on.
We didn't deliver on. That's a bad Christmas present right there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Setting. Sorry about that. But we're back and we're doing it now.
Yeah. Yeah. So I'm basically cheating for this one. I'm going to Reddit and looking at the thread of bad Christmas presents. All right, here we go. First post. My husband's stepmother gave me, a 36-year-old at the time, a kindergarten-sized backpack. When I opened it, she said, I actually bought it for a child a few years ago, and she hated it. So I threw it in the closet, and I thought you'd like it. None of us did. We all think it's ugly.
That's pretty good.
That is pretty good. At least the backpack is usable in some sense, even though it's like... I picture one of those like kind of small like Dora the Explorer type things.
Yeah, like those vinyl ones.
Yeah, yeah.
That are just no. Those are terrible. But still,
like I said, at least it's a little bit usable. At least,
Yeah, definitely. I got one.
Yeah,
from my life.
Okay,
I got a gift card from the body shop.
Oh, okay.
When I was like 7.
Yeah. Gonna go in and buy some bath bombs.
Yeah. I was like 7, maybe 8. I don't know, but like, you shouldn't bathe. Like, baths are gross, by the way.
Yeah. Yeah, it's basically you soup.
Yeah, you're just marinating in your own broth.
Your own juices, yeah.
If you're gonna do it, you gotta like bathe, drain it, do it again, drain it, rinse and repeat.
Waste a ton of water.
It's not going anywhere.
No, I'm a shower man, so like.
Yeah, you got to shower. You should probably shower after a bath.
Probably, just to get like the you juice off of you, for sure.
Yeah, sorry, got in the weeds there. But don't give 7-year-olds body shop gift cards.
Yeah, yeah.
That's my advice, at least.
Yeah, give them like. Toys R Us or something.
Yeah. And I don't even know who it was from. It was anonymous.
Like, from a secret admirer.
Yeah, I just showed up and was like,
yeah.
Okay.
Check this one out. This post says, my mom is notorious for bad presents. I've had such delights such as toothpaste and vitamin pills wrapped up for me for Christmas.
Hold on. Read that again.
I've had such delights such as toothpaste and vitamin pills wrapped up for me for Christmas. So Christmas morning, like opening up, I don't know, some Flintstones.
Toothpaste isn't a terrible gift.
I could see it as like a stocking stuffer.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You get those, like the fun size toothpaste.
Yeah.
I don't know if they still make those or not, but.
They do make like travel size kits.
Because little shampoos, but toothpaste.
Yeah, yeah, could be useful.
Yeah. I wouldn't be upset about that.
Yeah,
dental hygiene is important.
It is.
Yeah, we're getting.
Let's see what. What's that? A dish towel. I was 8 years old.
I can kind of relate.
Yeah, that's up there with the bath bomb.
The body shop.
Body shop.
Are they still around?
I have no idea.
Yeah, I'm not a big bath bomb guy, so.
Yeah. I'm just looking for, like, little short ones.
All right. I'll try to talk and fill some time.
Fill in.
So Carol Baskin did an AMA on Reddit.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
I missed it. I don't know how that got past me.
I've seen the first couple episodes of the second season, because the second season
is... Oh, you're watching it? Yeah. I haven't seen it.
It's not quite as compelling as, like, the first season. Because the first season, you had that episode, it's like, yeah, these people are pretty out there, whatever. And then they ended off like the first episode, the first season with, and this lady probably killed her husband. And then it just kind of went downhill from there. A lot of it does focus the second season, though, about the disappearance of her husband. And they kind of Yeah, they go down to like Puerto Rico or whatever, and like talk to like some of the business associates that that guy had down there. And there's some.
So is it more about Carol Baskin than?
It's. I mean, Joe's in jail, so yeah, there's only so much they can do with him. Like they. They kind of cover the thing where he asked for the presidential pardon, which we all know didn't really turn out.
Didn't look better, yeah.
Yeah. It kind of felt like the people on the outside were more capitalizing on Joe. Joe was like, yeah, I think they kind of went too far getting the limo and stuff. And, you know.
Oh, man.
Yeah, within the first, like, three episodes, Joe almost seems like the most reasonable person so far, which is kind of crazy because the whole thing was nuts. We're now a Tiger King podcast, by the way.
Yeah. There you go. So, weren't we talking about something else?
Yeah, Christmas presents. Bad Christmas presents.
Actually, you know what? I'm a pivot a little bit.
Yeah, go for it.
To a great Christmas present.
Okay.
Socks.
Socks are always useful.
Yeah. They get dogged a lot. And I'm not talking about the socks that come in like the Ziploc bag.
Yeah.
Or the like fancy like Argyle kind. Like socks that are basically like gloves for your feet.
Yeah.
Those things are amazing. Not the like the individual toes.
No, that's weird.
Yeah, it's creepy.
Yeah. I
but like a solid sock?
A good sock, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's always kind of a joke in my family when I was growing up. Like, I would get socks every year. But the socks were always from, they weren't like from the family. They were always labeled as from Santa. So it's like the guy supposedly has like a toy warehouse and a slave lady, slave lady. What? Slave army of elves building toys. But he's got a warehouse full of socks that, you know. It was always the thing. I'd always get socks from Santa every year, which is fine.
Oh, yeah. Like this is a pro sock podcast.
Yeah.
What the hell, Santa? Come on. You can do better than that.
I wanted a GameCube. No. These are socks.
But yes, a killer pair of socks or?
Yeah.
Well, hopefully more than a pair, but yeah.
Yeah.
Thumbs up.
I'm trying to think of my best gift. Got a pair of cross-country skis 1 year. That was fun.
Oh, nice.
Yeah. Damn. Really like to get back into that, actually. It's good exercise.
Oh, for sure.
What else? I got like a really neat like RC car 1 year that had like tracks on it. Nice. Remember when RC vehicles, you'd see like advertised on like television all the time? Usually Saturday morning.
Yeah, like this one does the loop.
This one does the loop.
Yeah, that was great.
3 hours of battery time.
And you just sat there and hold the trigger?
Well, those were the slot cars.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's where I'm going to. And they'd always fly off the corners.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. There'd always be like a loop-to-loop in the commercial, no matter what.
Do they still make those?
Slot cars? I'm pretty sure they do.
I haven't been in the toy section in a really long time, so I have
idea. Don't even... I mean, every year you get like the Sears Wish Book.
Yeah.
At least here in Canada. I think they had it in the States as well. But like you get it like September and then you go to the back and then like the next few months we're like looking at the back of that Sears Wish Book and saying, oh man, it'd be cool if I had like the G.I. Joe aircraft carrier that takes up half the room.
Buddy of mine still has one of those.
That's probably worth bank.
It is.
Yeah.
It's crazy.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, man. That was...
That, well,
I mean, I guess we got like an Amazon catalog.
Yeah, we did get an Amazon. But it's weird because there's no prices or anything. It's just like, yeah, we have this.
What? It's like, well, of course you do. You're Amazon.
Well, I mean, their prices kind of shift around a lot.
Yeah. That's true.
Yeah.
I mean, don't get me wrong. I love me some Amazon.
Yeah.
They have... done me well.
I mean, do kids like play with toys? I feel like toys are more like a collector's item now.
Yeah, right?
Yeah. I mean, I have a, like, within the last couple of years, like, I bought, like, a few reissued Transformers.
Nice.
Because, like, I didn't get them when I was a kid. It's like, I want Optimus Prime. I've never had Optimus Prime, so I bought myself Optimus Prime. Yeah, not the old one. It's like a reissued one, but...
Oh, that doesn't matter.
Yeah, I now have Optimus Prime.
Yeah.
Yeah.
There you go. Pick yourself up a Lino.
Yeah. I have a Ghostbusters car.
Oh, what? Really?
Yeah, I had the car and I had the four guys. That was the best Christmas present, actually.
There you go.
Yeah, I got that, I think it was four. Like, it was pre-kindergarten. Like, nice. So that would have been like 1987. Yeah, I got the car and the four Ghostbusters for Christmas that year.
I had Egon.
Yeah.
I think that might have been it.
They did, like, another, like, they kept reissuing them with, like, be like, and now they have, like, scary faces, and you flip a button, and it will, like, flip to, like, a scary face.
Oh, yeah, yeah, I remember those. Yeah,
it's the sports Ghostbusters, that kind of thing.
I'm definitely going to have to cut to that.
Yeah.
Ghostbusters! Spangler, this lab is spooky.
Benjamin, yuck, it's ahead.
Ah, it's full speed ahead!
What an eyeful. Let's split.
Great car. Step on it. Vroom.
Yikes, it's Highway Haunter. Looks like he got a rise out of you.
We're out of here.
The real Ghostbusters. Each sold separately. New from Kenner.
Safe.
Well, apparently the new movie's out now.
Yeah,
Yeah, the audience score is like 96% and the critic score is like 63%. So,
which is, they never balance out.
No, it's always one extreme or the other. Yeah. Usually the critics love it, the audience hate it, or it's the other way around.
I don't get it.
No.
Yeah, so I'm just sitting here thinking about why that.
I've heard rumblings that are coming. They're going to re-release High C Cooler though, like Ecto Cooler.
Okay.
it's like
why not?
Yeah. I never had that when I was a kid, but you always see it advertised, like High C Ecto or whatever it was.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No, I'm down.
I'm pretty sure I've eaten Ghostbusters like SpaghettiOs, though, when I was a kid.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. I had those. Yeah. Those are, I mean,
it's just like SpaghettiOs. It was like a vague shape of like the no symbol or stuff like that.
Like a goat? Kind of a ghost?
Kind of a ghost, yeah. There's only so much you can do with pasta.
Shout out to SpaghettiOs.
Yeah.
This is a pro SpaghettiO podcast.
Yeah.
We will defend SpaghettiOs.
There's nothing wrong with a can of SpaghettiOs.
That's the only point I'm here to make.
Yeah. Somehow we move from Christmas to SpaghettiOs.
Yeah. I mean, it makes sense, right?
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, man, I want SpaghettiOs.
I have to go to the store after this. I got a hankering for SpaghettiOs.
Yeah. Can I help you, sir?
Yeah.
No.
It's a weird thing. Like, I know that I could buy this back home where I grew up, but I've never seen it here. It's a can of, like, gravy and meatballs. I have not seen a can of gravy and meatballs here.
Really?
Yeah.
Huh.
And you can't order that, like, from Amazon or anything either. Like, where'd the gravy and meatballs go?
This is tripping me out because I feel like I've seen it.
You may have.
On the shelves in Kentown.
Maybe I missed it.
But maybe I could be totally wrong.
Yeah. Who knows?
Gravy and meatballs, where are you at?
Yeah. It's another like childhood favorite that's probably like...
Yeah. IKEA?
Yeah.
Man, their meatballs are ridiculously good.
I've heard.
You got to try them.
Yeah.
If you can find an IKEA, I know...
Yeah, we're not anywhere close to an IKEA.
But they're fantastic. Yeah. Oh, man.
Well, would you want some IKEA meatballs for Christmas?
Yeah. That would be a fantastic present.
There you go.
You can buy them frozen.
Yeah.
All of a sudden, we're shilling for IKEA.
I'm definitely pro meatball.
Hell yeah.
Yeah.
It's a ball of meat.
Yep. Especially get like a big one, get like some onion and stuff inside.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. You can customize it.
Yeah.
To no
extent. Get some like sweet and sour sauce or something on them.
I'm usually going spicy.
Yeah. For sure.
We always go to food.
We always record these like just before lunch, so that might be the...
Yeah, right. All right. Let's get back on topic.
Okay.
Maybe.
Do you got some Christmas presents or you want to pivot?
Oh, man, I'm stalling bad. Yeah, let's go to weird history.
All right, we'll move on to weird history.
I'm going to leave that pause in, by the
way. We are professionals.
Every Sunday.
Yep.
Do you want to go first? Do you want me to go first?
Yeah, you can go first.
Okay. 1518.
Yep.
The dancing craze.
Yeah, I've heard about
Germany,
that.
Germany, mass hysteria. Yeah. People... There was one... I guess it started with one woman, Frau Troflin, I believe. I'm probably pronouncing that wrong. But she started just tapping her toes, getting a beat going.
Yeah.
And people started joining in, and it just escalated, and people started... They estimated about 15 people a day were dying.
Yeah.
Just from dancing. Yeah. Nonstop.
Danced themselves to exhaustion. And.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's really the story.
There was a dancing plague. People couldn't stop dancing.
Yeah, in Germany in 1518.
Yeah.
They just started dancing and I guess, I don't know.
And there's no answer to you know, if it was a virus or.
Just a good beat.
Yeah. Maybe.
Yeah. I mean, microphones weren't around then, so we'll never know.
Yeah.
But maybe there is.
It was like.
Crushing a banger.
Their first time, Darude Sandstorm was.
Yeah.
Naturally occurring sandstorm. All right, here's my first one. I'm stealing all these from BuzzFeed, by the way, so take the validity of these. You might have to look it up on Snopes to see if these are actually valid or not.
Yeah.
All right. No. In the 13th century, Pope Gregory the Ninth declared war on cats.
Come again?
The Pope declared war on cats.
No.
Because they were witchy. They were associated with witches.
Oh, okay. I mean, I see the red string connecting the dots, but... Yeah.
Well, here's the other string. It's believed that because of all these cats were killed, the rat population increased, and then the Black Death came.
I mean, cats... I mean, you need a mouser.
Yep.
So maybe. Yeah, I believe that.
Yep. Yeah, there was a war on cats.
It's believable.
Yeah.
But, okay, so witches liked cats, so they got rid of the cats, and then the rats ran
rapid. Yeah, ran rapid. And then, of course, the rats were the plague carriers, so plague happened.
Mistakes were made.
Yep. Here's the fun thing that I like about popes, the fact that there were anti-popes.
What?
Yeah, there were anti-popes.
What do you mean?
There were, people who declared that, said that, the current pope wasn't valid. So they declared themselves their own pope, so they were the anti-pope.
I've never heard of this.
Yeah.
Were they Satanists?
No. They just didn't believe that the current real pope was popish enough.
Not my president?
Yeah, basically. Oh. So some people were declared the anti-pope.
Weird. That's what we're talking about.
Is there an anti-pope mobile? That's what I want to know. I want to see a comic between the pope and the anti-pope.
Yeah, a showdown.
Yeah.
That'd be great.
Apparently there were a bunch of them. There were 20 throughout.
What?
Yeah, 20 anti-popes.
You have to... Vanquish your opponent in hand-to-hand combat?
I guess.
I think that's how it should be settled.
Can you just declare yourself the anti-pope? That's what I want. Could I be the anti-pope?
Yeah, if you just say it, does that make you it?
I'm not Catholic, but, you know.
Same.
Yep.
Well, that probably qualifies you as more of an anti-pope.
You would think.
Being not Catholic.
Yeah. The un-pope.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right.
How do you pronounce Pope backwards?
E-pop.
There you go. Do that.
E-pop. Yeah. It's like K-pop, but more papal?
Yes.
Sure. What else you got?
The bullet in the tree.
Okay.
This is kind of a famous one.
Yeah.
But basically, a woman killed herself, and her brother was blamed her, I don't know, his husband or boyfriend, but the guy she was in a relationship with. And he tried to shoot him.
Yeah.
And he just kind of grazed him, and the bullet went into the tree behind him.
Yeah.
And then 20 years later, they went to just basically chop down the tree, but it was a big tree, so they had to blow it up.
Yeah.
Basically. TNT, I think. And then that bullet came, like, when they...
Blew it up?
Yeah.
It
shot the guy back.
So yeah. It's a two-shot bullet.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's kind of been debunked. Well, there's a lot of skepticism around it, whether yeah. it's a true story or not. Like, the names can't be found, but it is a cool story.
It seems plausible.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's like, dude tries to shoot a guy.
Yeah, it's basically like a piece of shrapnel, right? So.
Yeah. Yeah, totally.
Yeah.
But it's a validity is in question, I guess.
Yeah.
But
there's no solid.
Yeah.
No, solid evidence against it.
But still a fun story.
Yeah. All right. Second one for me. In 1820, an entire town held a trial against tomatoes.
Yours are way better than mine.
Like I said, I'm stealing mine from BuzzFeed, which probably stole it from Reddit.
Yeah,
if
probably.
If we're being honest. Yeah. The tangy red fruit was once considered evil and poisonous by much of the world. To dispel the rumors that tomatoes were lethal, Robert Gibbon Johnson ate a basket full of them in front of a crowd in Salem, New Jersey. We're astonished to see that he hadn't keeled over in one bite. So I guess they thought they were, like, poisonous for some reason.
Huh. Why, though?
Yeah. It was also a place called Salem, New Jersey. What's with Salem's?
Yeah. Don't.
They don't have a good history. Like, don't call your community Salem.
Yeah, just don't do it.
Yeah.
You're asking for trouble. Oh, man. I went to high school with a kid who would eat tomatoes like they were apples. Freak me out.
Yeah.
It was upsetting.
It's kind of a... It's one of those things that isn't illegal, but feels wrong.
Yeah, it's just, it ain't right.
Yeah.
I know it's technically a fruit.
Yeah.
Which is fine. But don't do that.
No.
Chop it up.
Yeah.
Put it in something.
Cherry tomatoes, just eat cherry tomatoes. Yeah. If you're going to go that way, eat cherry tomatoes. Pop it in your mouth. Good to go.
I'll compromise and agree with that.
Yeah. Yes.
But a whole tomato, like a beefsteak tomato and just chomping into it?
Yep. No.
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 We're trying to live in a polite society. That's not how you do it.
Listen, there are rules, okay? Some not written, but there are rules.
Yeah. Like everyone knows not to do that.
Yeah.
It's unspoken.
All right. What do you got next?
Oh, is it my turn?
Yeah.
The whole thing about turkeys, if you leave them out in the rain, they just kind of look up.
And drown?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Not true.
Okay.
I'm sorry, everybody.
Oh.
I want to live in a world where that is true. Because it's...
Just
I don't know
look
why.
At the window and there's a bunch of turkeys with their heads up. Like, oh, no.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, I'm just the bearer of bad news today.
Yeah.
Man, I'm sorry.
Do you ever...
what's that?
Speaking of animals, did you ever see... footage of the time that they blew up a whale with dynamite on a beach?
I think I don't think I've seen the video, but I think I've seen pictures of it.
It's fantastic.
Oh man, I'm gonna have to look that up and cut that in right about here.
Speaking of weird history, at one point they blew a whale up with dynamite. I think it like wrecked somebody's car too, because like there were bits flying for like miles.
I think you're right.
Yeah, because they used so much.
Oh, okay. This is gonna take like an hour of interneting.
Oh man. All right, going back to the tomato theme.
Yeah, yeah,
yeah. Ketchup was once sold as medicine.
Really?
Yeah. Well, I mean, everything was once sold as medicine.
Yeah,
heroin, cocaine.
Blood loss?
Yeah. By some leeches?
Leeches actually do work.
Yeah.
In certain cases.
Yeah. And maggots.
Yeah.
Maggots will only eat dead flesh, so if they're trying to get...
If you've got gangrene?
Yeah, if you've got gangrene, they'll cover you with maggots and they'll eat away the dead flesh.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But they got to be careful. Like, they got to get them all out.
Oh, yeah, for sure. Time. Yeah, no, you don't want, like, bloat flies and stuff, like, coming at you. It's, apparently, it was concentrated in the pill form and so as well. So
ketchup pills?
I don't know how you can get ketchup pills, but apparently they were a thing.
Can you? Are they available? I want to see if we can buy these. I want to buy some ketchup pills.
All right, well, you do your next one. Let me see if I can find ketchup pills.
The Iron Maiden. The sarcophagus that they would put you in, that on the inside, you'd basically stand up and it would penetrate you with, like, with these spikes and you'd slowly bleed to death. Also not true. Well, it's debatable, but
yeah, it's,
it didn't show up until it's kind of like art becoming reality. It seems, allegedly.
All right, I found...
Oh, you got something?
It's basically like red capsules.
I imagine they'd be red.
Yeah. And I've also found like some old-timey ads from the 1800s.
Nice.
Yep. Sick of being cooped up at home? Catch up with life. Dr. Kilkenny's ketchup.
Hey, red sugar.
That'll fix you up. Oh.
I mean, ketchup is pretty good.
It is.
So we're not dogpiling on ketchup.
All right. Going back to Roman times, Roman Emperor Caligula planned to make his favorite horse a senator.
Okay. I'm okay with that.
Well, I mean, I think one of the Canadian prime ministers, one of the like, early ones, like used to consult with those like dead dog. I think it was like Mackenzie King or something like that. One of the old Canadian PMs.
Man. Politicians, not even once.
Nope. get another one?
I think I'm out.
You think? Okay.
But, I do have a question.
Sure.
What would happen in science fiction if aliens landed on Earth today? I know not all sci-fi is like alien based. Like there's like Planet of the Apes and stuff like that, or like a
Blade Runner type stuff.
Well, even Ghostbusters, right?
Yeah, that's sci-fi.
But what would happen? Would it just destroy the industry, or
I'm
a thought experiment. Sorry, everybody.
I mean, a good amount of sci-fi is kind of us versus them, Starship Troopers type.
Yeah.
You know, definitely. Aliens are the bad guys.
Like, would it ruin it? It was just like, oh, it's not really science fiction anymore.
Yeah.
Do we still write about it? Or do you move on? Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, I think, you know, science fiction would still be around, but probably the topics would be changed.
Yeah. I feel like it would ruin, like, a lot of writers' careers.
Yeah.
It's like, yeah, crap, aliens are here. I don't know what to write about now.
Okay. All right. Here's another weird historical fact.
Oh.
In Victorian England, people used to take pictures of their dead relatives in lifelike positions to keep as mementos.
I did know that one.
Yeah, that you've seen.
I've seen that.
Yeah.
It's.
They basically like tie them up in a chair just so they don't slump over and.
Kind of weekend at Bernie's.
Yeah.
It.
Well, it's like the last photo that you have with them.
I get it.
Yeah. Well, I mean, there's the whole waking thing as well, like which was like big in Ireland. Like you'd have the body in like your living room, and you keep it there for like 3 days just to make sure like the guy didn't just like wake up before you buried him.
Better safe than sorry, right?
Yeah. Well, I mean, I don't have this on the list or whatever, but like. People used to have like graves with like bells that would run down to the casket.
Yeah, in case,
and then they ring the bell just in case, like you woke up in the coffin
on a stool, just like sitting there.
Yeah, just waiting, just to see.
Graveyard shift.
Yeah, This one you probably knew as well. Before alarm clocks, there were people called knocker-uppers who would literally knock on people's windows to wake them up in time for work.
I didn't know that.
No?
No.
Yeah, people would go around and, like, rap on your door at, like, 6 o'clock in the morning. It's like, time to get up.
That is a... Yeah.
Be a professional knocker-upper.
That is a honorable profession.
Yeah.
Well done, whoever did that.
I like this one. 1923, a jockey died in the middle of a race but still won.
I think I might have heard about this one. Yeah. Didn't he even have a heart attack?
Yeah, he had a heart attack in the middle of the race, but the horse reached the finish line first, so...
It counts?
Yeah. Here's the part that I like in what they have in this article. Hayes won, but sadly also was last. I mean, hopefully it was his last.
Yeah, it's probably time to call it a wrap if you...
Yeah.
Well, I mean, he died, right?
Yeah, so. Unless you weekend at Bernie's like your jockey.
have him on poles.
Lash him down. Nobody says he's got to be alive.
Yeah, maybe that's not a rule.
There's no rules about dogs playing basketball.
That's true.
Yeah. Ancient Romans often used stale urine as mouthwash.
That's not surprising.
Yep. Apparently it had some of the best natural cleaning agents. It was also used to make colored dyes more effective. I heard about the dyes thing as well that they used. Apparently the ammonia in the urine helps that out.
So, are we wasting urine?
We could be. I think we found more effective ways to do things.
Yeah, probably.
Yep.
Maybe that's a step backwards.
Yep.
I don't think we need to.
Roman gladiators often became celebrities and even endorsed products, a lot like athletes do today. And I knew about this because apparently in the script for the original Gladiator movie,
yeah.
They actually had that. They had really? Russell Crowe's character like endorsing products, but they cut it from the script because nobody believed that like it was actually a thing.
Well, fame and advertising definitely go hand in hand.
Yeah, you'd have...
It makes sense.
Bruticus or whatever, like saying, this is my favorite clay tablet.
Yeah, you get a sword sponsorship.
Yeah. Bostonius's bronze is the best. Oh, boy. Also, gladiator sweat was considered an aphrodisiac. So I don't know if like they're like toweling down the gladiators afterwards and then...
Man, sex and violence.
Yep. Well, Roman times were like...
They were all about crazy. It.
Well, even before Photoshop, Stalin would literally have his photos retouched to remove people he didn't like.
I've seen that.
Yeah.
That's crazy. I don't know how they did it.
Well, the article I'm looking at is like starts with like 4 people, then it's down to 3, then it's down to 1, and then it's just like Stalin.
This is him?
Yep.
I'm just going to take a selfie.
Yeah.
Or at least make it look like it was a selfie.
The only person I like is myself.
We got something wrong on the last episode.
Did we?
Yep. We said Boris Yeltsin. Oh, wait, no. We got the Russian guy wrong with the wine stain on his head.
Yeah, okay.
We said...
That wasn't Yeltsin?
Gorbachev,
yep.
Yeah, we got that wrong. Yeah. So, correction made.
There we go.
We're back in good standings.
Between the 11th and 19th century, a number of Buddhist monks successfully mummified themselves.
What?
Yeah.
Nice.
They adopted a practice called Soku Shinbutsu. I probably butchered that.
It sounds like you nailed it.
Yeah, Soku Shinbutsu. In which they gradually wean themselves off food and water, essentially starve themselves to death over the course of 1,000 days.
1,000 days?
Yeah.
That's like years. Holy crap, that's like 4.5 years?
Yeah, I think they would eat like pine needles or something like that, something that would like dehydrate them.
I can't endorse or condone that.
Mummifying yourself?
Yeah.
No.
I'm not saying I'm against mummification.
No.
But not like that.
No.
That's...
What's your favorite type of mummy?
Ooh, well, Egyptian. Obviously.
Yeah, the classic?
Yeah.
I Kind of like the bog mummies.
Well, those are good.
Yeah.
But I'm going like Boris Karloff.
Yeah.
I got it.
Okay, fair enough.
Maybe I'm old school. I don't know.
All right, here we go. A novel about a seemingly unsinkable ship that was hit by an iceberg was published in 1898, 14 years before the Titanic sunk. The name of the ship in the novel was called the Titan.
There you go.
Yeah.
Well, I got nothing with that one. I was like,
it's like, good guess, I guess. This is the last one for the article. I've heard about this one before as well. Charlie Chaplin once entered a Charlie Chaplin look-alike contest and came in 20th place.
Yeah, I've heard that one. That one's hilarious. Yeah. I feel like he almost did that on purpose.
I can see entering the contest on purpose, yes, but...
Like he... Because he wore makeup and stuff.
Yeah.
So, like, I could see him... disguising himself as not him.
Yeah.
Or, which is, I guess, just a disguise. So I can see that being like a troll.
Yeah. I've also, I can't confirm this right now. I've also heard about, musicians who, enter, karaoke contests.
Yeah.
They do their own stuff, and then they end up in, second place.
Didn't that happen to Dolly Parton?
I think maybe.
I might be getting this wrong.
Yeah.
But, yeah, someone like that. Yeah, it was, a super,
known.
Not even famous, just iconic.
Yeah,
persons, they lose the contest.
I keep thinking U2 for some reason.
I'm still mad at them for forcing their album on my phone.
Oh yeah, yeah. Who does that?
Can I shove my album, which I don't have yet? If I make an album
one day,
can I shove it on Bono's phone?
Yeah,
take it.
His Nokia.
His flip phone.
His flip phone. I could see Bono having a flip phone. That seems Bono's speed.
Yeah, he's all that. Yeah. I mean, yeah, I don't got much to say about Bono. But I'm still a little salty about that whole album drop.
Yeah.
Didn't appreciate that.
You brought up Dolly Parton. I do know, there's a couple Dolly Parton things that she's well-liked.
Dolly Parton's fantastic.
Yeah. Apparently, she...
Jolene?
Yeah. I think if you write her and ask for a kid's book, she'll send your kids, books or something like that. There's some sort of...
Oh, yeah. Yeah, she has, a book program.
Yeah.
I don't know much about it.
And apparently, I think whatever region she grew up in or, she lives in had, one of the lowest graduation rates around. And then so she basically made scholarships. Okay, if you graduate, here's $500. And rates went through the roof. So she's good for literacy and all that stuff. She's
nice.
Great person.
Yeah.
Good on Dolly.
Yeah.
She's working 9 to 5.
Okay, so this is a podcast all about Dolly Parton.
Dolly Parton now.
I would have no problem doing an entire Dolly Parton podcast.
Oh, didn't she do a movie with Stallone? Was that Rhinestone Cowboy?
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, I think that was Dolly and Stallone. I could be wrong.
I think.
Okay. You're going to look that up?
Yeah, I'm going to pull this up right now. Hold on a second. If you can just kind of run offense for a minute.
Sure. Listen, gangster rap might be hard, but Loretta Lynn is harder.
Fist City?
Yeah.
Fist City. Just look that up. Because.
I mean, The whole beef thing, man. She also did You Ain't Woman Enough to Take My Man. That's kind of hard.
Oh, yeah. She's tough as nails.
Yeah.
I'm trying my best not to swear because Loretta Lynn is just...
Yeah. And speaking of movies, there was a movie about her called Coal Miner's Daughter. It had Tommy Lee Jones and...
Sissy Spacek.
Sissy Spacek.
Love that movie.
Spacek. I can't say Spacek.
Sissy Spacek. It is a little tricky.
It's a lot of S's.
Yeah. I'm going to have to use the de-esser.
De-esser, yep.
What was I looking at?
Rhinestone Cowboy?
This is bad television.
Do.
I'm trying, man. Our internet is not working right. Ryan.
I'm going to give it a shot as well. Okay.
Yeah, find another. BuzzFeed article or whatever the hell you looked at.
Hold on. Rhinestone Cowboy movie. Yes.
Yes, it was.
Yeah.
Sylvester Stallone, Dolly Parton.
It's got a 14% on Rotten Tomatoes.
Oh, get out of here.
A 4 out of 10 on IMDb. Its budget was $28 million, and it took in $21 million, so.
Ooh, came in at a loss, eh?
Yeah. Well, I want to see the audience score, though, for Rotten Tomatoes for this.
That's got to happen.
Because the critics.
at least a cult following.
35?
Really?
Yeah.
Oof.
That is pretty bad.
Nah,
but
screw
yeah.
that. That movie is awesome. Dolly Parton rocks.
You got a young Sly Stallone. Like, I don't know if it's post-Rocky or not. Man, Stallone's got a lot of poorly rated movies.
Yeah. Over the Top, though. I love that movie. I don't care what anyone says. That movie's amazing.
I love the fact that they thought it was going to be so popular that they set up arm wrestling like leagues.
Oh, it should have worked.
How did he receive a 10% audience score from going on Jimmy Kimmel in 2010?
What?
I know Jimmy Kimmel's not the most liked, but wow. I'm just looking at Stallone movies now. Yeah. Nighthawks. What's your favorite Rocky movie?
My favorite Rocky movie? Ooh. I don't even know if that seems like a trap. That seems like a trick question.
How so? You can have a favorite.
You got Mr. T.
Rocky 3, yeah.
And then you got Dolph Lundgren.
Yeah. Apparently they re-released Rocky 4 this year. It's called Rocky IV, Rocky versus Drago.
And then there's like that one like with Tommy Gunn.
That was Rocky V.
Yeah.
Yeah. That was...
I'll go Rocky 2.
Yep. Rocky 2, solid. I do have a soft spot for Rocky 4.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, yeah, it is.
That's
a gem. Like, it is good.
Because you got Hearts on Fire for the training montage.
Yeah.
You know, going to Russia. He basically solves the Cold War. In a boxing match.
You will lose.
Yeah.
I will destroy you.
I must kill you.
Oh, man, they're all good.
Yeah.
Up until 5. 5 is debatable.
Best Rambo movie?
The second one.
Yeah. First Blood Part 2.
Yeah.
Have you seen the last Rambo movie that they put out?
Which one was the last one? Because I saw like the...
Came out in 2019, Rambo Last Blood.
I don't think... I saw the one before that.
Okay.
It was kind of like the comeback Rambo?
Yeah, the one where he's... he's in like a South Asian...
Yeah, in Cambodia, I think?
Yeah. I remember some really bad CGI in that. There's a shot where like a famous scene where like somebody's guts get exposed and it looks super bad.
Mistakes were made.
Mistakes were made.
It was still fun. It was still fun to watch.
Yeah.
I liked it.
I have not seen any of the Expendable movies.
I can't say I have either. Or, no.
Yeah. Nothing about them really. Like, they did. You know, it's basically like a big crossover thing where they have like all the big action stars, but I've never actually seen one.
Did they ever make the female version of that one? I know there was talks, but I don't know if it ever...
I don't think they actually did.
There's like Sigourney Weaver, Linda Hamilton.
Yeah. Judge Dredd. Remember that one?
Which one?
I am the law.
I definitely have to look that up.
Why did you judge me?
You killed innocent people.
The means to an end.
You started a massacre.
I caused the revolution.
You betrayed the law.
It's got Rob Schneider.
Yeah.
I'm not sure why, but
he's just kind of in there.
The Carl Urban Dread was a lot better.
Yes.
Yeah.
But that was basically just a remake of Raid.
Yeah, kind of.
This running around a building just killing people. But it just felt like a paint by numbers kind of. I mean, it was still cool.
Yeah.
I'm not trash talking it. But it felt like a Raid remake for sure.
Yeah. I like that universe though, kind of like the mega city, type thing. That's like post-apocalyptic. Everyone just lives in squalor in the future. Based on an old comic, I think it might actually it wasn't in Heavy Metal. It was in, I think it's like 2000 AD or something like that. I haven't actually read any of the old Dread stuff.
Yeah, that was never a comic I really explored.
Yeah. It's more British.
Is it? Is that like an Alan Moore project or something?
It could be.
Probably not.
Yeah.
I feel like.
But yeah, I think it was like kind of in like a British comic magazine type thing. Basically the English version of heavy metal.
Okay.
Because like Heavy Metal was originally French.
Yeah, Ralph Bakshi.
Yeah.
Give us a follow, man. I follow you on Twitter, so you can at least give a like.
There you go.
That's a big ask.
There you go. Speaking of comics, do you have like an old favorite?
Ooh. Saga.
Yep, Saga.
Saga's great.
Apparently there's a new issue coming out soon.
Yeah, they're kind of...
Yeah.
I'm not really...
Apparently it's been a while.
It's been a minute for sure.
Yeah.
But it was just the old classic X-Men. I was definitely a Marvel kid.
Yeah.
DC, I had no interest in.
Yeah, I liked... Wait, sorry.
Swamp Thing. Was that Marvel or DC?
Swamp Thing's DC.
Okay.
Have you seen the old Swamp King movie, like the 1980s version?
Swamp King?
Swamp Thing, yeah. Swamp King is like Tiger King, but in a swamp.
Yeah. Yeah, who did that? Was it Wes Craven?
Yeah, it was Craven.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No, I love that movie. It was great.
It's like, there's like a sex scene where they eat a pickle.
Yeah. Yeah, it was weird, but it's still amazing.
Yeah. Apparently, like, the guy who did it, it was like his first like foray into like comic movies. Like, he had like the rights to like a few like DC properties. And I think originally he wanted to do Batman, but Batman was like too big to like budget wise.
So give you a Swamp Thing.
Started with Swamp Thing.
No, that's a great movie.
Yeah. It's a bit weird.
Oh, it's strange. It's
I haven't seen strange. It though, but I remember like the scene where they like eat the pickle.
Oh, you haven't seen it? Dude, watch
it. No, I've seen it.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, but it's been like 20 years.
Well, yeah. I haven't. It's not like I watched it this week or anything. I might have to do that tonight.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, it's so good.
Craven Swamp Thing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Wes Craven. Well done, sir.
Yeah, that was a bit of a... I think Craven at the time was like, he didn't want to be pigeonholed as like a horror guy. Mm. So that's why they went in that direction.
Yeah, that's fantastic.
Yeah. Do you have a favorite Craven movie?
I mean, the obvious answer is Nightmare.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know. Do you?
I've
never been a huge Wes Craven fan.
Yeah. Did he do Hills Have Eyes?
Yes, I think so.
Yeah.
I might be wrong, but I'm pretty sure he did. Actually, yeah, that was a... Oh, man. I always get Wes Craven and John Carpenter mixed up.
Yeah.
Because I know one of the two did Last House on the Left.
Yeah.
I want to say Craven...
Insert like caption with like correct.
Yeah. I'm gonna have to make a graphic on wrong.
Yeah.
I think it's Wes Craven who did Last House on the Left.
Yeah. Well.
Yeah. I mean, how are we doing for time?
We've hit 50 minutes.
Cool.
Yeah. Want to wrap it up there?
Yeah.
Save ourselves like a few megabytes.
Oh man. A couple gigs.
BitChute,
what happened, man? Wait, yeah. Why? Okay.
We won't get into it.
Yeah.
Well, thank you so much for watching. I'm Michael Forward.
I'm Chris Raskowski. Please like and subscribe and do all that internet stuff.
Yeah, if you have any topic suggestions, let us know. Comment.
Yeah. Let us know when we're wrong, because it happens quite often.
Oh, yeah. We are literally talking out of some orifice.
Yeah, below the equator.
Yep.
All right. That is a great note to end on.
Bye.
See you next time.